Now, the lamina has a large number of vascular strands, veins. In your junior classes, you have drawn such diagram. This is called venation. So, lamina carries a large number of vascular strands, which are called as veins. And this pattern is called as venation. And then the lamina is specialized for one main function. What is that? Photosynthesis. And then it is a site of the transpiration, loss of water from stomata, as well as for exchange of gases, mean respiration again from stomata. So what are the three functions of the lamina? You can say photosynthesis, it's a site of transpiration, and it is a site of the respiration. Now the next part present in the shoot system is the flower. So flower, at the later stage shoot, now it's not like suddenly the flower will come. A particular age has to be crossed. That age is the vegetative phase or young phase has to be over. Then only mature phase or reproductive phase will start. This is your 12th class topic. So at later stage shoot will start bearing flowers. Flowers can be on the flowers can be in the axil of the leaf. Axil you have already covered in the last diagram, or on a special branch called as peduncle. Now, flower may be attached singly or it can be present in a bunch. If a flower is present in a bunch, then the axis is called as floral axis or peduncle. If the flower is present singly, or you can say solitary means alone, then it will be alone present in the axil. What is the peduncle or the flower axis? It is highly special. That topic will come later. Inflorescence topic is that. Now, a flower is a highly specialized condensed shoot that takes part in which reproduction? Sexual reproduction. It has a stalk or a pedicel. Now, there are some terms which you have to remember. If there is a leaf stalk is called as petiole. If there is a flower, its stalk is called as pedicel. You can write PDCEL also, both spellings are correct. If there is a bundle of flowers arranged together on a axis, this axis is called as peduncle. So petiole, pedicel and peduncle, be clear with these three names. So the next point is, it has a stalk called as pedicel. You can put CLE or CEL, both are correct, which ends into a broad surface called as thalamus or torus. We'll be learning about this in the flower description. Now, there are four different type of things present on the flower. You have learned this in the junior classes: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx means sepals, corolla means petals, androecium means stamens, gynoecium means carpel or pistil. The individual whorls are called by these names. Sepal and petals are non-essential. Why? Because without them also sexual reproduction is possible. And the stamens and carpels are essential because without them sexual reproduction is not possible. Stamen consists of anther. Anther carries pollen grains inside. And anther is attached with a filament. And carpel is made up of stigma, style and ovary. These diagrams you have learned in junior classes. Ovary contains one or more oval structures called as ovules. Now, remember the flower or the ovary modifies into fruits. So, after fertilization, pollination, fruits form. And fruit wall is called as pericarp. And it has one or more seeds inside. And seeds carry the next generation inside. So root, stem and leaves are called as vegetative portions. And flower, fruits and seeds are concerned with reproduction. So they are called as reproductive organs of the plant. Now let's understand the morphology of the root. So what are the basic characteristics of the root? So first point is, it is non-green cylindrical organ that constitute the descending axis of the plant. So whatever goes down into the soil is the root system, is the part of root system. Because it goes down, so it is non-green cylindrical portion, and it is not distinguished into nodes and internodes. It does not bear leaves and buds. A functional root is covered with at its tip by a root cap. Root cap is protective in nature, and near the tip it will have unicellular tubular root hairs. These structures are called as root hairs. Lateral roots develop endogenously. This topic will come in the sixth chapter of plant anatomy. So wait, what is pericycle and what do you mean by endogenous? It is neutral or negatively phototropic. Generally, roots are negatively phototropic, but they can be neutral also. And they are positively geotropic as well as positively hydrotropic. So moving towards the center of the gravity and moving towards the water. Now, what are the various parts of the root? So the various parts of the roots are, now NCRT has a different way. NCRT calls the various zones as root cap zone, meristematic zone, elongation zone, and straightaway maturation zone. There is no root hair zone in the NCRT. So you read accordingly, but I have given you the complete description. So root cap zone is the zone. Now you can see here, the tip of the root is covered with a cap. So that's why this cap portion is called as the root cap zone. Is the cap-like structure present at the tip of the root, its cells secrete mucilage. Now, why mucilage? To reduce friction, because the root has to drill its way through the soil, and there can be rock, there can be big stones, there can be gravel, so all sand could be there. So all these things will cause friction and will cause damage to the root. That's why it prepares a slippery thing on its surface called as mucilage, which lubricates the passage of the roots through the soil. Its cells also possess starch grain, responsible for perception of gravity. So how it understands the direction of this gravity or geotropism is possible because of the starch grain. Its outer cells are continuously peeled off because they are friction and replaced by new cells formed from the root meristem. Now, what is the next layer? The next zone is called as the meristematic zone. Remember, if this pen tip is the meristematic zone, root cap is covering some portion of the meristematic zone. So you can see in the picture also, some portion of meristematic zone is under the root cap zone. So meristematic zone is few millimeter in length and lies partially covered with the root cap and partially exposed. The cells of this zone divide actively and add new cells to the root.